The 10th Crossy Road Castle Tower is called the Wind-Up Workshop. That means the gem quest continues. If you're not sure what that means, there's a Crossy Road Castle playlist. But in summary, Crossy Road Castle is an exclusive game on Apple Arcade. It's kind of like Nintendo's Super Mario, but with a theme based on the original Crossy Road. And in Crossy Road Castle, you can play as many different characters. This tower introduces four new prize machine characters. The Rusty Robot, the Rubber Duck, the Tyrannosaurus Rex, and the Symbol Monkey. That part is pretty straightforward. Just collect enough tokens. This video is about finding the five secret gems, which unlocks a mystery character. So let's get that started. Super Mario immediately popped into my head when I saw this. It's a tube to zoom through the level. So if you're seeing levels that look like that, watch out for a level that looks like this. Instead of taking the tube, simply jump to the green door at the top left. That's why this tower is especially challenging. It's hard to notice a green door when all of the walls are green. But once on the other side, be quick. It's a race to the gem. Just keep jumping up the conveyor belt before the enemy reaches the switch. Don't overdo it though, or the gem will be unreachable. A turbo controller is recommended for this tower. It can make it easier to reach the first gem, but even more so for the second gem. That's why I'm glad that I have an 8-bit Do Pro 2 controller. I set one of the buttons to rapid fire, so that I could regular jump or turbo jump. And if you see a level that looks like this, then you're just about to see the perfect opportunity for turbo. But at first, be careful. Reaching this green door is not so easy. It's another vertical conveyor belt. Just ride it to the top of the level. You can get a more dramatic view in local multiplayer mode. It's a long way down, so don't fall. That might happen when trying to jump to the ledge at the top left. If you're fast enough, or simply lucky, you can recover if you fall. Once at the top, simply walk through the door to the second gem room. This level, right here, is my favorite part of the new tower. Just look how easy it is with the turbo controller. It's fast too. And there are many coins at the top. The second gem is there too. That was a lot of fun. Let's see that again. Awesome. And since I enjoy this level so much, here's an alternate way to the gem room. Crossy Road Castle randomizes the levels, so it's important to adapt. The actual gem rooms are consistent though. Once you find them, they don't change. Nice and simple. Gem number 3 is not so easy. Actually, it's the opposite. It's the one I found to be the most difficult on this tower. It starts with a room with counterclockwise moving platforms. This part is not too bad. The first platform launches you up. From there, it's kinda like a backwards clock. Just take the green door on the upper left. From there, many swinging platforms are found. I had a lot of trouble reaching the second swing. You'll need great timing to make these jumps. If you fall down, then the gem becomes unreachable. That's why I brought these guys with me. Using several controllers, I was able to get multiple chances at the gem. This tower seems better designed for multiplayer. The new emotes certainly highlight that. So, if you can make it to the top, you can get the third gem. I was disappointed when leaving the live stream, unable to reach this gem. But it did take a lot of time offline to finally get it. Never send a prince to do a cat's job. There it is. The mystery character is a ballerina. It was anticlimactic. I suppose she's not a bad character, since she's not as annoying as the schoolgirl or the merlady. But she doesn't seem to fit this area. It's kind of like STEM, science, technology, engineering, mathematics, and toys. That seems to be the theme of the tower. I suppose that's the theme of this channel too. But basically I was quite disappointed with the character. I'm glad I wasn't broadcasting live at the time. By the way, thanks to those that joined the live stream, it was a lot of fun. However, this quest is not over. In addition to the remaining gems, there is another secret character to unlock. One that is more fitting for this tower. So let's get those other gems. But if you are trying to get all 5 gems, you'll likely meet this boss. It's a peacock. I'm surprised there isn't an emoji for that. Anyway, I was quite confused when I first saw the boss. What was I supposed to do? Then it became quite obvious. It's like Guitar Hero. Basically, hit the corresponding switches as the notes reach the last row. This is probably the easiest boss in the game. Unfortunately, that makes the battles kinda dull. There are no coins to collect, and there's not much variety. Although, with multiple players, it might be fun. And probably even easier, too. Yet, there's something interesting about that. The other players don't actually have to do anything. They can stay safe right at the start. The projectiles won't even reach the box. Anyway, after 3 rounds of punching and stomping switches, the bird will be defeated. To get the 4th gem... What? Data collection? Hipster whale, if you want to know how I play, just watch the Photix TV videos. So, to get the 4th gem, look for a tube level that looks like this. These tubes are a lot of fun. On this particular level, the green door is at the top. The wind-up workshop is one of my favorite towers, but this level... it might frustrate you. Basically, the tubes move in a wave pattern. The goal is to stay on the middle path. If you get too close to the top pipes, you'll be pulled to the upper row. If you get too close to the lower pipes, you'll be pulled below. It's actually a great level design. Let's zoom out so you can get a really good look at it. The trick is short hops. If you make a full jump, you'll hit the upper pipes. So, as you hop over the waves, try to stay low. Not too low though, because if you don't jump over the waves and pipes, the gem is lost. This one is tricky, as it's part timing and part skill. But if you can get to the other side, that's gem number 4. Gem number 5 starts out in a similar way. If you see 3 tubes like this, it's the one on the lower right. What's nice about this level is that you can try again if you miss. So, at least getting to gem number 5 is somewhat easy. But actually getting gem number 5 is a little tricky. 2 large structures push you forward. As you travel through the level, the goal is to hit 3 switches. In other words, turn the red switches green. A good strategy is to not panic. Instead of trying to stay ahead of the moving block, just let it push you. That way, you only have to focus on timing your jumps. Once you make it to the end, that's gem number 5. Once you have all 5 gems, and completed all of the other stickers, you can try to reach level 100. There's a separate Photix TV video that shows that journey. But, once you have all of the stickers complete, that unlocks the Jack in the Box. That's a good match for this tower, as it's a collection of classic toys. If you look in the background, you can see them. How many of these toys did you have? And what do you think of the ballerina? Or the Jack in the Box? You can let everyone know in the comments. Hopefully this video helped you out, and thanks for watching.